Hello and welcome to Back to the Feature, the show where we talk about movies past, present, and future. And today, we're going into the past to 1987, and we're talking about an absolute action sci-fi horror classic. Yes, we are talking about the movie of movies, Predator.
This is heavy duty, Doc. This is great. 21
gigawatts. Predator is a quintessential action movie, Arnold movie, 80s movie, horror movie, sci-fi. It goes on and on. This is a tome of the modern era. And I know we were really excited to get the chance to be able to do Predator. When we saw it was on our list for this year, we're like, oh yeah, we get to finally dig into something like this. So, I mean, without too much more preamble, John, what is your kind of your history with Predator and, you know, and then your experience, of course, watching it now more recently for our review?
Well, you know, just off the bat, this movie holds up really, really well. And I was, it's funny because I was showing my wife, who's not really a big movie watcher, but, you know, I was showing her the trailer for it.
This poor woman,
and,
right?
And I was just kind of like, the 87 trailer for it is so silly and like, ridiculous for it. I'm watching, I'm just kind of like, the trailer doesn't do this movie justice. It really doesn't. This movie's awesome. But it, just growing up as a kid, okay, I remember seeing this VHS tape sitting at the, you know, the local video store, and I'd walk past it, and I'd see, like, Arnold on the cover. I always wanted to watch it. I never got the chance until I was probably 13 or 14, somewhere in that range, the first time I watched this movie. But I remember being really little and just always wanting to watch that movie.
It was sitting there on the shelf shining at you.
It was. It was one I always eyeballed every time I was at the video store. I wanted to watch it so bad.
There's always those movies growing up. And Predator is something that I remember I saw it on television first. So it was edited, I think.
Okay.
To my knowledge. But I was also, I think I was a bit younger than you were. I was probably maybe like 10 or 11 when I first saw it. So me seeing it on TV was probably appropriate. And then I eventually, I mean, because I've seen it a few times now at this point. And then I eventually did, of course, see it, you know, proper and see everything and, you know, been ripping spines out and just go. you know, and then of course, you know, it's just, it's of that era of 80s movies of just the really, just the adrenaline filled, super macho guys with guns and big muscles and, you know, just, it's so quintessential.
The arm wrestling handshake.
You son of a bitch.
If you have ever questioned, like, your level of fitness, You're just going to feel ashamed when you see that.
Oh yeah.
Like, I mean, just, I mean, Weathers is like the little twink in that situation, and he like is ripped in this movie. Arnold is like at peak Arnie. I mean, just the body mass alone.
Jesse Ventura thrown in there.
I mean, his name was the body. So yeah, this movie is just like just a hulk of muscles and just badassery.
This movie definitely transcends the 80s, though. I mean, it's like, you know, you got those, like, kind of like those cheesy 80s tropes, but it really, like, the movie, John McTiernan, he really filmed this movie so well. Like, he's the director of the Die Hard series. So, I mean, and this is right before the first Die Hard movie came out. And the level of filmmaking in this is excellent. It's so good. The camera work is so strong, and, like, the movie's just edited really well. It's just a trip, like an awesome action movie trip. Going through it, so I don't know. You know, it's just like watching it again, like just this past weekend. It's still like such an entertaining action film.
Yeah, and I think that's the biggest thing with Predator is that it's just endlessly entertaining. Like, it's not asking for anyone to pretend that it's a highbrow piece of cinema. This is an action thrill ride. You know what I mean? It is like a roller coaster type movie. I always talk about that when I talk about like James Cameron. And the things you feel when you're watching, like even the best parts of The Abyss have that kind of feeling where it feels like you're riding this
really
fun roller coaster, these really event action movies, and I think that Predator has that. It is just kind of, it just has this pulse and this pace to it, and like I said, of course, like with that cast and just kind of the mood of it. I mean, and also, like you said, with kind of that 80s-ness to it, that 80s machismo, we'll say, that this movie has that, like, that, like I said, it's just, it has this extra little oomph behind it, and there's, there's something about this movie that I think that even now we have movies that have similar stakes. The way that it's filmed, the way that it's put together, you feel those stakes. You feel that they're up against the wall. I think one of the great things about this is, you know, as we're talking jokingly about the body mass of this movie, but I think it's so important that all of these guys are these super fucking tough guys when they go up against this thing and they get demolished, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
they just caught me just, like, torn apart.
Yeah, and it adds to, like, that fear factor. I mean, you watching, like, you know, Jesse the Body Ventura, and I love how cocky he is. I love all of his one-liners. Jesse the Body Ventura is awesome in this movie. He's just, he gets all the best lines, really.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then it's like, you know, 30-year-old movie, spoilers, but when he goes down, it's like, yeah, I mean, you see all the other ones turn, but then the movie turns too with
it.
Like,
totally.
You're like, holy crap, like, these guys that, like, are, you know,
they're up against the wall.
Yeah,
the
they're up against
ever,
the wall,
probably,
and these guys could probably, like, tear down a wall with their bare fucking hands, you know what I mean? Like, so I think that it really adds to how scary this is. You're like, if this, like, crew of beefcakes can't take this predator out, like, what chance does anyone have?
Now, you were talking, too, a little bit about, like, maybe not, it's not maybe the highest of, like, pristine filmmaking qualities,
no.
But I would argue that, I mean, there's a lot, there's so many of the individual aspects of this film that are top-notch. That,
oh, yeah.
And, like, seeing it, like, the Metascore and, like, the Rotten Tomatoes score of this film, it really doesn't do it justice.
No, I think, yeah.
I think critics really did get this movie wrong, or there's just something about it they didn't really quite get about this movie, but I mean, like, Alan Silvestri, the score for this film, is fantastic. For those of you who don't know, he was the guy that created Back to the Future. I mean, the theme song to Back to the Future, that is iconic, memorable. But then, like, Stan Winston's creature design in this movie, too.
Oh, yeah.
And Stan Winston, I mean, he's, like, the man when it comes to, you know, practical effects with The Thing and Jurassic Park and Aliens. I mean, just all the greats.
Yeah.
And
I mean,
the predator design
predator.
Is awesome.
And it hasn't changed. I think that says so much.
Yeah.
It has not changed. Like, we have better technology to create it, like, just to look a little more detailed or to show it a little bit more. But the Predator costume, when they show it, is fucking phenomenal.
Yeah, it is.
Like, it is iconic. I mean, you think about it, this is something that, I mean, we're still seeing Predator movies.
Yeah, Shane
Black's
coming out next
year. Shane Black, this next year. And I mean, too, like, you think that the Alien and the Predator stuff crossing over, it's such a huge thing, and it was all in the merit of, I mean, really, like, a few scenes. I mean, most of the movie, we don't see the Predator until the third act.
Which is good films, yes.
Yes.
Good filmmaking.
But when you do, like I said, that creature design is so fucking awesome that it helps stand the test of time. It helps the movie stand the test
fun,
of time.
Fun little fact, too. The face, like the mandibles on the Predator, was actually James Cameron's idea. He was, Stan Winston was flying to someplace with James Cameron, and he was drawing the Predator, and James Cameron was kind of threw that out there. I've always wanted to see an alien with, like, these mandibles, and he's like, shh, you know, there it is.
Yeah.
It just,
well, there he goes, James Cameron raising the bar just once again. But yeah, I like I said, yeah, that creature design, it's iconic. It stands the test of time. It's gone unchanged now for 30 years ever since people saw it in this film. I think that speaks volumes about this movie, and this movie has that in more ways than just one, because it's a great Arnold movie.
Yeah, it is. Arnold is actually, like, I mean, yeah, there's some, I mean, it, there's a peak, there's
stick
a scene
around.
Stick around.
It's like probably the one actual, like, 80s one-liner.
He's got, well, yeah, I mean,
because the rest of them are more creative, or, like, things that people,
like,
remember,
knock,
like, get to
knock.
Knock, knock.
Yeah, but it's all in that one scene.
Yeah, it's all in that
the one
scene
where it's super 80s, because, like, all this of the Jesse the Body Ventura says, and then the stuff that people remember Arnold saying weren't said as one line, like, get to the chopper.
Yeah,
he says that
a
couple times, actually. It's because it's a destination. He's
yeah,
like, get there. You know? But yeah, I think that, like,
Arnold's pretty good in this movie, though.
Yeah.
I mean, it's one of his better performances. He is solid. His line delivery is actually pretty good. I mean, he's a little shaky at times. You know, Arnold always is.
We know what
bit.
To expect from Arnie, and I think that,
but
like,
this is like top notch Arnie.
Yeah. I think this is some of his best stuff. And the thing is, though, is that I think Arnold, in a way, is underrated. Yeah, he was never maybe as good at acting as his contemporaries like Bruce Willis and Sylvester Stallone. But at the same time, he has charisma. He has ability to act and to sell certain things. And I think that as an action star, he is kind of in a lot of ways unparalleled. I mean, this is a guy who shouldn't be able to act at all. He's just, he was Mr. Universe, and he came over here and, you know, became a movie star and then a politician.
Think of Bill Burr's
I absolutely love that.
it's a long sketch. Just YouTube that.
But, Arnold is really, really good in this movie. It's one of his best films overall. Like I said, they don't demand lots from the cast. It doesn't need tons of stuff, but I think that the overall of this cast does do a really good job of being able to keep this movie going along. Yeah, the characterization isn't overly complicated, but
it doesn't have to be. Yeah, there's soldiers going into the Amazon to save some hostages from, you know, these guerrilla terrorists.
Yeah.
Okay. And then what's hunting them in the woods is an alien from another planet who hunts for sport. I love that is told too, like the Predator. There's no exposition describing what the Predator is and what he's doing. There's just the one scene where, like, he's just like, he's hunting, you know, it's for sport.
Yeah.
He's hunting for sport. And then, like, that's the legacy of Predator, like, beyond. And it's just that one line, it's just what he's doing in that scene.
And there's definitely interesting characterization that it's really, it's selling it short to say that it's really simple. And I think that, like, so say a character like Mac, you know, is a supporting character. Anytime. You know what I mean? That guy. You know, there's so many interesting little things that go on with the character, the way that he reacts to things, the way that, like I said, those little scenes like that, I think are vastly more interesting than they should have had to be.
Yeah, the team definitely functions, like, Carl Weathers and Arnold, like, the way, like, they definitely are believable, like, they, mm-hmm. like, they work together in the past. Like, that is, that is stuff that you do believe, and it's just really well done. It's simple, but it doesn't need to be complex, you know?
Yeah, I think it's a lot of, like, the movie's ideas and, like, just the kind of building dread and the adrenaline rush of the movie. I think that it's what makes it, I mean, a truly, truly just great, amazing action movie.
Yes.
So we've kind of gone back and forth then with some of the things that we've had to say so far about Predator. But, John, what is your strongest moment of the movie for Predator? And what is, like, your weakest part or element?
I think the strongest part is the same. It's what we've been talking about. You'd probably agree with it, right? This, when he jumps over the waterfall and comes out, it's kind of like the first time the Predator is truly, like, visualized, and Arnold sees it, like, fully, like, hiding there with the mud on him, and it just kind of, like, you know, going back and forth with his guns, scanning the area, trying to look. It's such a tense moment in the film, and it's just like, oh my gosh, like, it's right there, you know. It's such a well done scene. Least favorite moment, I don't know, you know, it's not really, I don't think, the movie just keeps going along, so it just keeps clipping so well.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, I mean, there's some silly one-liners in it, but I'm not gonna complain about that. I think it's fun, you know, it's awesome. So I don't know. I guess I don't really have that many negatives in this film or anything that really, like, lags it behind, I guess.
Yeah, you definitely picked my favorite moment, and it's kind of what we were saying before about this movie's legacy, and I think it really comes from that moment. It's this, I mean, it's kind of, in a way, the money shot of the movie for me, like, of just that, when he's on the rocks like that and you see the cloaking come off and he's searching for Arnold, you know, because it's finally when Arnold realizes that he can actually fight back, too.
Yeah.
That he has a way to hide from it. I mean, he knows if it bleeds, we can kill it. Which, again, it's got so many great one-liners that aren't even trying to be one-liners. But I think that, like I said, that is the legacy moment. That is the moment that solidified the Predator and that creature design in the, the memory of audiences, and why I think it sticks around now, why we're still talking about it right now, 30 years later, and talking about it in the way that we are.
Another moment that I really like, too, is the scene where I think the Predator takes his mask off, you know, and you actually fully see the face, and then he, like, challenges Arnold to kind of, like, hand-to-hand combat.
Yeah.
And he just grabs Arnold and just lifts him off the ground, slams him up against the rock, and just roars in his face. It's iconic. That's iconic. And it's crazy, too, because you actually see, like, how big this creature is.
Yeah.
And the guy underneath the suit, too, you know, but he's just lifting him off the ground. Arnold. You know, that's like, oh.
These guys are like gods among men, kind of, like, being, you know, thrown around with playthings. Yeah, I think that's definitely a great moment as well. You know, I think for me, though, as far as, like, what I didn't like as much, I think it's a little bit toward the beginning of the movie. There's a really great video by Rossitron, another YouTuber, who kind of points out some of these second unit directing action sequences, and ever since I've seen that, it's really hard for me to watch it. It is cut together very poorly. It is really hard to quite tell what's going on when they kind of take over that camp and they're fighting these humans. And then too, it's got the really hammy one-liners. It's got the stick around. It's got the knock-knock. Like I said, I think what I think is fantastic with the later end of the movie and the one-liners that people really know from it is the ones that they're not trying to be. Like, get to the choppa. He's not trying to make that a one-liner. He's not trying to make if it bleeds, we can kill it, a one-liner necessarily. It's just a really good fucking line.
Yeah, it's just something that's
and get to the chopper, I think it's just because of just iconic delivery.
And just how Arnold sounds when he says
it. Of course.
Just,
yeah, it's a great one that you could try to imitate Arnold while saying, get to the chopper! You know, you just pretend you're an Austrian man just chowing down on the sausage. But yeah, I think that like that's what makes those things really great is that he's really not trying to deliver these hammy one-liners. Where like that scene really has some more of that, and maybe not some of the strongest direction of the film, but the rest of the film is pure iconic magic. So John, what is your final grade and summary for Predator?
I love Predator. It's quintessential. It's just a memorable creature design, iconic creature design, and it's lived on. I can't wait for Shane Black's Predator coming out next year. I really hope it's good. I really hope that it sticks to you know what this movie established. But it's classic Arnold. It's so much fun. It's an amazing action movie. It's directed really well, and it's got a very memorable score and one of my favorite scores from the 80s. Honestly, I think it really. Like that sci-fi feel that like John Williams kind of brought to the Star Wars. I really did feel that in the score in this movie. It's so good. Besides that, some of the cheesy stuff in it, you know, some of the, like that action scene, it is, the editing isn't perfect in that, you know, in that scene, but, you know, everything else holds up really well. And man, we were discussing this. I'll probably give this movie an A-.
And it's great that you mentioned Shane Black and his 2017 The Predator. As a lot of us know already, Shane Black is actually in this film as an actor.
Yeah.
He a very young Shane Black. I honestly didn't think he was the funniest part, but he is definitely enjoyable, as is the rest of this movie. Like, if anybody can hopefully recreate some of the magic, it's hopefully a guy that was there while they were making it. And what this movie is that they made is an absolute action movie classic. Like I said, I think there's few movies that are as pulse-pounding adrenaline rides as Predator, and most of them are directed by a man named James Cameron or this same director, Mr. John McTiernan, with something like Die Hard. These are rare films, and I don't feel like we get action movies with just this kind of energy anymore. As we've said before, the creature design has stood the test of time. I mean, hell, every single NFL defensive back looks just like the Predator now because of it. And I have to say that at the end of the day, I'm going to give Predator a solid A. So guys, that has been our review today of Predator. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Tell us in the comments what you think about Predator, and tell us what your favorite line from Predator is, because there's so many iconic ones. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Like and subscribe here on YouTube. Find us on Twitter at Back2Feature, and you can find us on Facebook as well at /Back2Feature. I've been Giovanni Carlo.
And I'm John Vandaloup.
And we'll see you guys next time.